Today I'm going to discuss the topic for week 2, the subject past GT. So here we have the marine gas turbine, right? Brayton cycle. So our learning outcome for this topic is describe the operation principles in terms of four processes: compression, combustion, heating, expansion, and exhaust. So we have here the Brayton cycle, ideal gas cycle of gas turbine engine, which represents the operation of gas turbines engine. So we have to discuss the four processes consist in Brayton cycle: the adiabatic process, which is compression; the isobaric process, heat addition; adiabatic process, expansion; and isobaric process, heat reduction. So we have here the actual Brayton cycle is the ideal gas cycle of gas turbine engine, which represents the operation of gas turbine. So here, Brayton cycle or Joule cycle represents the operations of a gas turbine. The cycle consists of four processes. So we have here the adiabatic process. So adiabatic process or reversible compression in the inlet and compressor. So letter B, a constant. This is A and B. See here. So we have here E and B. So in this area, so we have here E and B. So in this area, E and B, adiabatic process or reversible process, compression. So this is compression here. E and B is compression. So this is compression here. So in the inlet and compressor. So here you have the inlet in your turbine here, and here you have the compressor. So in this area, E and B, this is E and this is B. So in this area here is the inlet and compressor. So now let us go to B to C. Constant pressure fuel combustion, idealize a constant pressure heat addition. So heat addition, heat addition. So here B and C, so this is B and this is C. So here is the composition, here is the addition, heat addition or ignition. That is ignition. So here, let us proceed to the C2D, the adiabatic. So remember, in B and C, this is heat addition or ignition. In E and B, this is adiabatic process. This is inlet and compressor. So, E and B. Now, the let us proceed to C2D. So this is also adiabatic process or reversible expansion. So remember, E2B is compression. So compression, adiabatic compression. But C2D is also adiabatic, but this is expansion in the turbine and the exhaust nozzle with. So here, C and D. So here, from here to there is adiabatic expansion. So here is, if we say adiabatic expansion, here is power. So adiabatic expansion. Adiabatic expansion. So this is rolling spinning. So there's here is compression is this is adiabatic compression. So these are the process of working process of the gas turbine. So here in the C2D, the adiabatic expansion, we have here, take some work out of the air used to drive the compressor. So, so what drive the compressor? So here, you have the turbine, this area. So you have the blade, this area. So the combustion occur here will drive the turbine. So this turbine, this is, since this is connected in the same shaft, the compressor here will also rotate together. So will rotate. So here, take the remaining work out used to accelerate it, use it to accelerate fluid for jet propulsion or to turn generator for nuclear power. So you can use this gas turbine, this gas turbine for jet propulsion, so the engine of the aircraft. And you can use also for this turbine force for to turn the generator for electrical power generation. So you can use this one. So remember, so we can continue here, down here. So remember, this heat rejection to atmosphere, this is open cycle. So this is open cycle. So remember the process, compression, Here is the ignition, heat addition, and adiabatic expansion. So first, adiabatic compression, second is ignition, adiabatic expansion, and exhaust here, exhaust. So we have here an simple video here, simple zip file or JIT file, the working process of gas turbine. So here, this is inlet. So inlet. And this is the compressor. Here, this is compressor, and here is the inlet. So now, the in this area here, the process here is adiabatic. So adiabatic. Compression, so second we have here the combustion chamber, this area. So this area is a combustion chamber. So here you have the heat addition. So here heat addition. Or so a heat addition process or injection. And combustion. So next we have here, so I will erase this circle that you can see. You have here this one is the turbine. So you have here the power. Or in the process is this is it's the delay. Adiabatic expansion. So you have the adiabatic expansion here. So here the inlet of air. Because of the suction happening here, So there's a little bit, and there is a compression inside this compressor, and then here heat addition, there is a spray of fuel, and since this one here, this area is this is a spray of fuel and ignition happen, so there is a combustion. So the combustion gas will cause the after passing the turbine blade here, the turbine will rotate. So there is power because this shaft is connected in this turbine blade. This is mounted. So there is a power happening here. So this is called adiabatic expansion process. And next we have here the heat rejection here. So in this area we have what we call heat rejection. So heat rejection, or in other words, exhaust. So exhaust. So that is the process of gas turbine. So what are the components of Brayton cycle device for jet propulsion? So we have here, we will typically represent these components schematically. So in this illustration, so we have here the components of gas turbine. So we have here the here the inlet. So inlet of air, so it is passing to the diffuser, this one diffuser. So after the diffuser, so this diffuser one, after the diffuser it will enter to the compressor number two. So here, so next to the compressor we have two burner here. So this burner, so number 3 is burner. So after burner we have the number 4 turbine. So after the turbine we have also another, this number 5 afterburner. So this is afterburner. So next we have the number 6 nozzle. So after nozzle we have here number 7. So this area is already this is exhaust. So this is exhaust. So these are the basic parts of the gas turbine. So Now we will compare the gas turbine to the reciprocating engine. So we'll compare now. So this is got gas turbine, this gas turbine. So we have here the intake, air intake. So this area. And we have here the compression. So here in the this area is compressor, and we have here the combustion. So this area is combustion chamber, and we have here the expansion. This area, the combustion gas expand. So this is this area is turbine. Here is combustion chamber. Here is compressor. So here we have here the exhaust. So exhaust is exhaust gas. To atmosphere. If the system is open cycle, so this is open cycle because this is aircraft engine. But if this is closed cycle, so later on we will see what is the closed cycle. So we'll be comparing the this engine to the reciprocating engine. So we have here air and fuel intake. So we have here the piston down. So this air and fuel intake here with the piston down, the intake valve, intake valve is open. So here, intake valve is open. So here, same also here, there is an intake of air. So this is also compressed, here also is also compressed. So next we have here the compression. So when the piston is going upward, intake and exhaust valve is closed, so there will be a compression happen. So it's the same here, there is a compression here. So now let's go to power. So here combustion. So we have here during power stroke. So this exhaust intake and exhaust valve is closed. So combustion. So combustion here. So after the combustion, the expansion of gas here inside will push the piston downward. So this is power stroke. This is compression, intake, yeah, and exhaust here. So, this area here is the combustion. So this also combustion here. This one here, the reciprocating engine. So after the power is completed, there is an exhaust, so the exhaust valve will so now the exhaust valve is open. So the piston going up, the piston pulls the exhaust gases outside here. So this one will lead to atmosphere. This exhaust gas, so this exhaust gas to atmosphere. the same head. So this is a comparison of the operation of the gas turbine and the reciprocating engine. So here we'll continue. So here's a simple diagram representing gas turbine. So this is closed cycle. This is closed cycle. So this represent thermodynamic knowledge gas turbine in the cycle for power generation. So this is closed cycle. So here is the compressor. This one is a combustor, and this one here is a turbine. Now, so we have here the there is a heat transfer. This one must be a heat exchanger. It's not responding. Why is that responding? So heat exchanger. This one also here is heat exchanger. So here, this is closed cycle. The exhaust gas here will enter to the heat exchanger to cool down the exhaust gas. Then it will circulate to the compressor here. So circulate. So this here is exhaust gas. Will circulate through heat exchanger and it will cool down again. So here we have also heat exchanger also to cool down the air inlet to the combustion chamber. So it will pass first heat exchanger here. So we have to heat exchanger. So this system is exhaust gas from the turbine here will recirculate to the compressor. So this is closed system. So again, it will supply to combustion chamber. Then it will pass through the heat exchanger here to cool down the air supply. So this is closed cycle. Second, we have, so here the exhaust gas will not exit of atmosphere. It will circulate to the compressor side of the turbine. So next, we have here the the open cycle here. Open cycle. Gas turbine. Now in the open cycle gas turbine, the air is coming from atmosphere. It's being sucked to the compressor and is being compressed. So it will deliver to the combustion chamber here. So the combustion happen here with the fuel and air supplied from here, compressor. So this is fresh air here. So after the combustion happen, it will pass through the turbine blade. So turbine blade, the combustion will cause to rotate when passing the turbine blade. So after passing here the combustion gas in the turbine blade, it will become a exhaust. Exhaust gas leading to atmosphere. So this atmosphere. What's this? Atmosphere. So remember that if open cycle gas turbine, the air suction supplied to the being sucked to the supplied to the turbine is coming from atmosphere, and the exhaust gas will also discharge also to atmosphere, whereas the closed cycle, the supply or this probably mix. So the supply of the air being sucked to the turbine, being sucked by the compressor, is coming from atmosphere and coming from the circulation from the exhaust of the turbine, and it will circulate again to the combustion chamber through the heat exchanger, and after the combustion, it will the combustion gas will rotate, cause to rotate the turbine blade here, and the exhaust gas will recirculate through heat exchanger here back to the compressor side. So that is closed cycle, whereas the open cycle, the fresh air is being sucked from atmosphere, so it will be sucked by the compressor and it will be supplied to the combustion chamber to mix with the fuel and air, and it will be combusted here, and the combustion gases will cause to rotate the turbine here with passing the blade, and the exhaust gas will release to atmosphere. So that is open cycle. So remember, if you can see the diagram in a closed circuit here, gas turbine, this is closed cycle. So that is close cycle gas turbine. is closed circle. But if you can see here is, there is no line here in the diagram, and there is no here. You see the here, this area, same like this. So this is open circle. So let us continue here with the Brayton cycle. So we'll be comparing the sprocketing engine to the rotary engine, which is less turbine. So now Brayton engine, a type engine, consists of three components: a compressor, a mixing chamber, and the expander. So first, we have first to compare with the reciprocating engine. So this is the reciprocating engine. So we have the intake valve here, and we have also the exhaust valve. We have the piston, so on, and we have here the this one is liner. So with the operation of the reciprocating engine, with the intake valve is open, supplied air is entering here or being sucked here to the cylinder, with the piston is at BDC. So here is BDC. And here is DDC. So DDC. So with the piston is going up, so this intake valve is closed. So now there is a compression happen here. So when the compression here is happen, at the piston at almost TDC, there is a spark of fuel here. And with the intake and exhaust valve is closed, there is a heat of combustion happen, and a spark of fuel here being ignited with a mixture of air, not air, and there is a combustion happen followed by the ignition. Then the expansion of gas here inside will push the piston downward to create power. So after power stroke, the open the exhaust valve is open to release the exhaust gas here to the atmosphere. So that is a sprocketing engine, internal combustion engine. So here we have to familiarize the components of the, here they have a simple illustration, component of gas turbine. So here you have the compressor wheel. So this one, so this compressor wheel. So the gas is entering here, gas inlet. So this is double this is what we call turbo expander. So in turbo expander you have here the compressor wheel and the gas here. This is the inlet of gas and this is the outlet of gas here, and to the other side also. So this is connected to the same shaft. We have here expander wheel. So this one expander wheel. So the gas is entering here and the gas is going out here. So with the turbine turbine with turbo expander. So in the modern So in the modern Brayton engine are almost always a turbine type, although Brayton only made piston engines in the original 19th century Brayton cycle. So it was piston engine. So here you can see here the piston engine. So here, this is piston engine because you can see inside there is a piston. So ambient air is drawn into the piston compressor where it compresses, ideally an isentropic process. The compressed air then runs through a mixing chamber where the fuel is added. An isobaric process. The pressurized air and fuel mixture is then ignited in an expansion cylinder and energy is released, causing the heated air and combustion products to expand through the piston cylinder. So another ideally isentropic process, sum of work extracted by the piston cylinder is used to drive the compressor through the crankshaft arrangement. So we have here the process. So gas turbine are also Brayton engines with three components: a gas compressor, a burner or combustion chamber, and a expansion turbine. So we have here the isentropic process here. So this is isentropic process. So ambient air is drawn into the compressor with it is pressurized. So where is this isentropic process here? So here we have here the diagram. So in this area here, is the process here is isentropic. isentropic, because as you can see here, ambient is drawn, ambient air is drawn into cryo pressure with is with where it is pressurized. So ambient temperature, meaning ambient fresh air, this air fresh air here is being sucked coming from the atmosphere, and it is being compressed here in the compressor. So that is isentropic process. So next, we have here the isobaric process. So this is isobaric process. The compressed air then rush through a combustion chamber where fuel is born, heating that air. A constant pressure process since the chamber is open to flow in and out. So isobaric process, we will mark in the diagram. So here this area, we have the isobaric process. That is isobaric process. So next, we will mark in the diagram the next process. We have here, so remember, in the turbine, there is two isobaric process. So first, it is found in the compressor, and the second we have here the isentropic process. The second isentropic process, this is, so the heated pressurized air then gives up its energy expanding through the turbine or series of turbines. Some of the work extracted by the turbine is used to drive the compressor. So here in the second isentropic process, this is called expansion. So expanding or expansion. So expansion because of the combustion gas here, so here isentropic expansion. Here is isentropic compression. So in the compressor, but in the turbine, isentropic expansion. Next, we have also isobaric process, heat rejection. So So we have here this area, we have here isobaric. So here is a heat addition in this isobaric process. This is heat addition. And here is the exhaust. Here is isobaric. Isobaric process. Heat rejection. So that is the process of the gas turbine. So we will use our PV diagram to illustrate this process. So I will erase this one so that I can write here. So we will be using the PV diagram. So pressure this is pressure volume diagram. So here from 1 to 2 from 1 to 2, so 1 to 2, here is the intake, and compression. So in this area, 1 to 2. Then 2 to 3, here is heat addition. So heat addition here. So combustion. So first we have to write first heat addition. Heat addition, combustion. Then 3 to 4 is expansion. Expansion power. Di Port 1 is exhaust. Heat rejection. So that is the process for illustrating the PV diagram. The gas turbine. So this Q out is exhaust, and this Q in is heat added. So this exhaust. This one is heat added. So that is the process of the gas turbine using the PV diagram. So we'll consider the TS diagram or the pressure volume diagram, this PV. So pressure volume diagram. And this one is entropy. So temperature entropy. Diagram. So I will erase this one. So we'll consider the temperature, the entropy diagram. So in this process, so from here, from 1 to 2, the entropy diagram, here is the intake. So 1 to 2 here. So by the way, in the PV diagram, the entropy or the S is constant. So 1 to 2 is constant. So S stand for entropy. So in the PV diagram, the 1 to 2, so PV diagram, one to two is constant. And so one to two is constant. So this is intake and compression. 3 and 4 is constant. So this is here is expansion. Expansion. So in the diagram, the intake and compression is constant, and the power or expansion is constant. But here we will consider the entropy diagram. So here is this one. So it says constant. So we will proceed to entropy diagram. So it's in entropy diagram, that is diagram. So here, the constant here in the entropy diagram are in order for you to understand when it says PV diagram is pressure and volume. Pressure and volume. When we use the test diagram, this is temperature. So this is pressure and temperature. So, in the PV diagram, the constant is entropy T. temperature, because is stand for stand for entropy. P stands for pressure. So, in the entropy diagram, the TS diagram, the point 2 to 3 is constant. And 4 to 1 is also constant pressure. So an entropy diagram, but in PV diagram 1 to 2 So here is T is diagram. Here is PB diagram. So PB diagram 1 to 2. Constant temperature. And 3 to 4 constant pressure. So in PV diagram, the constant is pressure. So 1 to 2, point 1 to 2 is temperature. 1 to 2 is constant temperature. And 3 to 4 is constant temperature. While the TS diagram, the temperature entropy diagram, 1.1 to 2, 2 to 3 is constant pressure, and 4 to 1 is constant pressure also. So we'll proceed. The idealized Brayton cycle, where P is pressure, V is volume, T is temperature, S is entropy, and Q is heat added, or it added to or rejected by the steam at the system, since neither the compression nor the expansion can be truly isentropic, losses through the compressor and the expander represent sources of inescapable working inefficiencies. In general, increasing the compressor ratio is the most direct way to increase the overall power output of the Brayton cycle. So we have here the efficiency of the ideal Brayton cycle is where is the heat capacity ratio. It indicates how the cycle efficiency changes with the increase in pressure ratio. Indicates how the specific power output changes with the increase in gas turbine inlet temperature for two different pressure ratio values. So we have here an example of the application of a gas turbine in a combination of steam turbine. So this is the combined cycle. So this is applied in a power plant. So this is power plant. So this combined cycle will have a efficiency of 50% more power. So this is more efficient. System. So why? So in a combined cycle, here is the turbine burning fuel. So this is burning fuel. So burning fuel. So this is burning fuel. So this turbine. Gas turbine is turning the, say for example, this one is generator, alternator. So this one. So this gas turbine turning the alternator to produce electricity. And then the exhaust gas here from the here in this area, exhaust gas, this exhaust. It's being recovered because this is already waste energy. So this exhaust gas, supposedly this is already waste energy. So this is being used for heating the water. So here is the economizer. Or EGB, exhaust gas boiler. So here, there is a coil here, so this is coil. This one is coil. And there is circulating fresh water here. So by the use of a pump, so you have a pump here. Your pump. This water is circulated through the coil of the economizer or the exhaust gas boiler, the EGB, is created here in the cooler. And to the other side, there is also passing the exhaust gas here. So here is the exhaust gas here. So when passing this hot exhaust gas, the water will boil, and the water will produce steam. So now this one is steam produce, and this steam produce will run the steam turbine. So this is steam turbine. So we'll post the blade. So the blade will cause to rotate. So now the generator, there are two turbine here driving the generator. So this one will add 50% more power. So more efficient. So if you are using 100% fuel to gas turbine, and the losses here is 50%. But if you combine with the steam turbine here, you can add more power, more power. Which is more 50% more. So this is good system, combination of gas turbine and steam turbine. So you see, if you have a generator here, then there are two engines will drive this generator, then you have a lot of power. So by the use of this recovery system here, which is the exhaust is used to heat the water to produce steam to drive the steam turbine, you can supposedly this exhaust is already waste going to the atmosphere. So this is to going to atmosphere. This is really waste, but now this is used to heat the water to produce steam to drive the steam turbine, and the steam turbine will help the will help to turn the alternator here. So 50% more power will be produced. So this is a very efficient system of a gas turbine. So this is applied to the combined cycle in the power plant. So let us proceed to the we have here the illustration of the Brayton cycle with regeneration. So by the way, what is regeneration? So Brayton cycle with regeneration. So uses a heat exchanger called a regenerator. So it is uses with heat exchanger or cooler. A cooler or heater. So to preheat the air fuel mixture before it is fed into the combustion chamber using the turbine effluent as the heat source. So as you can see here, there is a regenerator or heat exchanger. So this one, heat exchanger. So it says here to preheat. So you have to heat first the air and fuel mixture before it is fed to the combustion chamber. So here, you have the air So inlet air. So passing through compressor, it is compressed here the air. So here you have the, so this is air. So this one is air here. And this one is exhaust. So this is hot. So the air here is being preheat by your exhaust gases here before entering to the combustion chamber. So when entering to the combustion chamber, the air is already preheat. So preheat. So already increase the temperature. Now it is easy to burn here the air and fuel. So this is fuel. So the air and fuel, when it is, the air is preheated, so it is easily to burn. So the heat source here is the exhaust gas. So this is exhaust gas here. Exhaust gas. So this is exhaust gas. So that is the Brayton cycle with regeneration. So you have to preheat the air before it entering to the combustion chamber. So now here is the number one. So this is temperature, volume diagram. Now, number one here is inlet, air inlet. So number one, air inlet. The number two is compression. So compressed air. So number three is combustion. Or first is ignition. Ignition. And the number four is exhaust. Number five is regenerator. So five is heating. So before the, you see, the air is entering here, air inlet is entering here in the number one, and number two is compressor. So before it going to the combustion chamber, which is number three, it is preheated here in the number five. So this is heating. It is preheated air before entering to the combustion chamber. So at the number four, it is exhaust. So we will talk about the effectiveness of the system when using a regenerator. So now we have E, stands for effectiveness or efficiency, and we have Q, it stands for heat. So with generator, regenerator, we increase the efficiency of the gas turbine. So heat added, so actual this is this actual heat, so Q generator actual, then Q over Q generator regenerator maximum. So when we use this equation, when we write here, so effectiveness here due to the regenerator H5, can I read? So here is the H5 is a regenerator minus, so the air is being preheat by regenerator minus the air is not yet preheated minus H2 divided by H4. So here, so H4 is the supply exhaust gas to preheat the air here in the regenerator minus the H2. So minus H2 here. The air is not yet preheated. So that is how to calculate the effectiveness of the Brayton cycle with regeneration. So remember, regenerator regeneration uses heat exchanger to preheat the air and fuel mixture before it is fed into the combustion chamber here. So before the air and fuel mixture is fed to the combustion chamber, it is already preheated. And this is the equation on how to calculate the effectiveness of the regenerator. So next, we have here the Brayton and Rankine cycle. So this is combination. So Brayton cycle gas turbine and the Rankine cycle steam turbine. So this is remember the keyword. A Brayton cycle, this is gas turbine. A Rankine cycle, this is steam turbine. So this is the example where we discuss a while ago here, the combined system. So in this system, this is this one is Brayton cycle and Rankine cycle. Combine system. So this is the example. So let us talk about the system Brayton and Rankine cycle and the combined cycle. So the Brayton cycle, gas turbine, and the Rankine cycle, steam turbine, are two venerable cycles that have served mankind well. To combine these two cycles, a means to recover waste heat and the gas turbine and from the gas turbine must be provided. So remember, recover the waste heat from the gas turbine exhaust. So here we have here the this area here. Is gas turbine. And this area here is steam turbine. So now, as you can see here, there is a cheese over liver. So here is cheese over. So this probably, if you can you use this both of them together, you have to put the liver here in the center. So now so this is different. This one, if you don't want to use the steam turbine, you have to put the liver here. If you want to use the steam turbine, you put here. So synchronize. So here your turbine is running. So suction of air. So air here, compressor. So this is running. So it's running. So when it's running, this will drive the electric generator. When this turbine is running. But this is a combined cycle of Brayton and Rankine. We use the exhaust here, the exhaust. So this is exhaust. Exhaust gas. To heat the water here. So this is AGB, exhaust gas boiler or economizer. So the exhaust gas here is being recovered the waste. So this is already, this exhaust gas, this one is already heat waste. But we have to recover this waste heat from the gas turbine. This is turbine, gas turbine exhaust. So we have to recover. So this exhaust gas will preheat or will heat the water here. So by circulating by this pump here. So we have pump circulating water here. Circulating. There is water here in the other side of the coil, the inside or probably outside, and there is also passing here the other side, the exhaust gas, which is us. So this exhaust gas here will preheat the will heat the water to produce steam. So the produce steam will turn the turbine here, turbine blade. Turn the turbine blade, so turn the turbine shaft. So this turbine, steam turbine, is connected to the electric generator. So the electric generator rotates. So this producing electricity. And this one also produce electricity. So this is good system. You can add more 50% more power with combine not responding. So just wait for a moment. We combine cycle Brayton and Rankine. So remember, Brayton and Rankine cycle is a combination system of gas turbine and Rankine turbine. So gas turbine, Brayton cycle, and steam turbine, Rankine cycle. So remember, you can add more 50% power with this cycle, because instead of the gas turbine exhaust is, so this is stuck, exhaust is stuck, this is going to atmosphere. This is already waste going to atmosphere, but we will recover to use to heat the water in the AGB, the boiler, exhaust gas boiler, to produce steam so that the steam will run the steam turbine. So after here the boiler, the exhaust will go to stop, so to atmosphere. So this is exhaust stop. So to atmosphere. So this is a good system of Brayton and Rankine cycle. So we are here now in Brayton intercooling and reheating. So compared with the simple Brayton cycle with regeneration can produce same work with less heat input. Brayton cycle with intercooling and reheating and regeneration has the highest thermal efficiency. Remember, with intercooling and reheating has the highest thermal efficiency and larger work output. Also, it consumes more fuel due to reheating compared with the two cycles. So now, let us first mark the regenerator and intercooler. Reheating. So now we have here the turbine 1, turbine 2, compressor 1, and compressor 2. So they are connected in they are all connected in the same. Yeah. So now we will first Talk about the intercooling. By the way, what is intercooling? So from the word inter, intercooling. So inter or this one is inter. So intercooling. So now before the air, the air inlet to 1, so from atmosphere, air from atmosphere passing through compressor number 1. So after compressor number 1, the air will pass to number 2. So 2 and 3, number 2, so this is already hot because it already passed through the compressor. So this is hot air. So this already hot air, we will cool this air by the use of intercooler. So before entering, so this is intercooling, this is correct, I just emphasize here the inter is entering. So this is intercooling, that is correct. So the heat, the after passing the compressor 1, the air after passing the air through the compressor 1, the air is hot. So it will pass through the intercooler. So after the intercooler, it will enter to the compressor 2. So after entering to the compressor 2, it will enter to the regenerator, which is 4. So this one is regenerator. So the air is preheat here, preheat. So remember that with only regenerator, the air here is preheat. So now in this system, reheating and intercooling, the compressor 1, the air is compressed and it will pass through the intercooler to cool the air before entering the compressor 2. So after the compressor 2, it will be hot again. So why you need to preheat? Because from compressor 1, you need to intercool or to cool this air. From the compressor 1, the air is hot. So hot. So it will need to cool down before entering to compressor 2 to avoid the damage of the compressor parts. Then when already this one is when passing the air to compressor 2, it will be passing again to the regenerator to preheat the air before entering to combustion chamber. So we have here the fuel. So fuel. So here you have already more efficiency because of the regenerator. So now this one here, the combustion happen in the combustion chamber, so it will pass to the turbine to turn this turbine. So pass to the blade of the turbine. So the blade is mounted to the shaft, so this one will turn. So the exhaust, you have to reheat again. So there is a reheating. So reheat again the exhaust. So if you reheat again the exhaust, it will pass to the turbine number 2. So this turbine number 2 will help to turn this shaft. So you have more power because you have turbine 1 and turbine 2. So you have more power. So this exhaust gas here will pass to regenerator to preheat the air before entering combustion chamber. And after that, the exhaust gas will be going to atmosphere. Is this atmosphere? So atmosphere, now let us discuss the problem related to Brayton cycle calculation. So we have here the simple ideal Brayton cycle. Brayton cycle sample. So here we have a sample problem. A gas turbine power plant operating on an ideal Brayton cycle has a pressure of a pressure ratio of 8. The gas temperature is 300 Kelvin at the compressor inlet. And 1300 Kelvin at turbine inlet. Utilizing the air standard assumption, determine the gas temperature at the exits of the compressor and the turbine. B, the back work ratio, and C, the thermal efficiency. So if we are going to draw, so we'll so here, so that is not good drawing. So the problem says that the gas temperature is 300 Kelvin at the compressor inlet. So here, so it's not responding. So here is 300 Kelvin. And the turbine inlet is 1300 Kelvin. So here we have 1000 300 Kelvin. So utilizing the air standard assumption, determine a gas temperature at exits of the compressor. So here we have to solve the gas temperature exit gas temperature from the compressor and the turbine. So exit from the turbine, so here this is exhaust gas, so this area. So B, back work ratio, and C, the thermal efficiency of the turbine. So now we have here the diagram . So here we have here the reciprocal P2 over, so I will so here we have here P2 over P1 is equal to 8. So this one here. Now, we have here the temperature 1, 300 Kelvin. And the temperature 3 is 1,300 Kelvin. So we have to solve temperature 2 here and temperature 4 here, as well as the temperature 3. So now so using this TS diagram or the temperature entropy diagram, so assumption is steady operating condition exists. Number 2, the air standard assumptions are applicable. Number 3, kinetic and potential energy changes are negligible. Number 4, the variation of the specific heat with temperature is to be considered. So we have here the analysis. The temperature entropy diagram of the ideal Brayton cycle described is shown in 9-35, figure 9-35. So this one, we note that the components involved in the Brayton cycle are steady flow devices. So letter A, the air temperatures at the compressor and turbine exits are determined from isentropic relation. So we have here, we have to calculate now the process 1 to 2. So here, so here 1 2 2, so the isentropic process. So remember, isentropic process the events involved here is intake from 1 to 2, intake and compression. So intake of air, fresh air, then compress here at the 2. So now isentropic process or isentropic compression of an ideal gas. So we have now the equation here. Temperature 1 is equal to, so the given 300 Kelvin minus the 300 Kelvin, the equivalent enthalpy, so this is enthalpy, each one is 319 kilojoule per kilogram from table A17. So here, we have here the table A17. So look at this. This is table A17. Ideal gas properties of air is a unit. So we have here. In 300 Kelvin, you see this one, temperature, 300 Kelvin, the equivalent enthalpy in kilojoule per kilogram is 300.19. So we have to write here. So each one is equal to 300.19 kilogram per kilojoule. So now this is our ideal gas equation. Isentropic process. So temperature, pressure to the power of 1 minus Q1 divide Q is equal to constant. So now this is the equation. This one. So temperature to times pressure to the power of 1 minus Q over Q is equal to temperature 1 multiplied by pressure 1 to the power of minus to the power of 1 minus K over K. So here we will continue the calculation here. So here we have to calculate temperature to, because temperature to is not given. So remember that our formula here is this one. So we have to derive this or rearrange this formula. So here, I show you how to rearrange this formula. So I rearrange this formula. So this one was the formula, the equation. Temperature to, pressure to the power 1 minus Q over Q is equal to temperature 1 multiplied by P1 to the power of 1 minus K over K. So I rearrange this formula. So temperature 2 is equal to temperature 1. This one. Temperature 2 is equal to temperature 1. So here, since we have here the we have also to multiply this pressure 2 to pressure to and pressure to temperature to. So this one to temperature 1, because the unknown here is temperature to. So temperature 1 multiplied by pressure to. So we have to transfer here the pressure to over the pressure 1. So we have to transfer here. So to the power of 1 minus Q over Q. So now we already rearrange the formula. So we will substitute. So P2 is equal to 8 here. In the entropy diagram, this diagram. So P2 now is, so RP is equal to P2 over P1. So we assume now starting P1 is 1. So P2 over P1 is equal to 8. So we will substitute. We will substitute here. So now we will substitute. So I This formula is mistake, so I rearrange here. So where is this? So I rearrange here. So supposedly, temperature 2 is equal to temperature 1 multiplied by P2 over P1 to the power of 1 minus K over K. So I rearrange here. So we have to substitute temperature 1, which is 300 Kelvin. So P2 is 8. So divide 1. So it's 8. So here in the 1 minus the value in the table here is this is, so from the table this 1.4 is 1.3860 in the table, so this is round up. So here, so where is this? This one here. So the pressure 1, you see the equivalent of the pressure 1 here, we have, or pressure 1, we have here the 1.3860, which is Q1. So we write here, we round up here 1.4. So this is 1.4. So I'll double check. So we have here 1.360. So this is, we round up here in the exponent. So 1.4. So this one, 1.4. So we write here, so what is this? So we write here 1 minus 1.4 over 1.4. So now if you calculate this one, you you do like this: 1.4 minus 1 is equal to 0.4 divided by 1.4. This one is the result. So 0.28571. So we have to, in your calculator, scientific calculator, you have to press 8. So press 8. Press 8. Then press XY in your scientific calculator. Then press this. So press this data, this exponent. Or enter this. Responding. So in it is. So into this. So if press it and then press XY in your scientific calculator, then enter this this 0.28571 then equals, then press equals, so then multiplied by 300, this will be your Tito 543.43. So that is the answer, that is the Pito. Now we will calculate here. So we got already the temperature to here. So this temperature to. Now we have to calculate the enthalpy. It's 2. So here we have to trace where is this calculation came from. So now I rewrite here and rearrange the arrangement here. So where it's to, so this one here. So I rearrange, it should be written like this. So it's to minus 544.35 over 5.74 minus 544.35 is equal to 543.43 minus 540 over 550.540. So where is this value taken from? So now we have on the table. So 543, it says here H2 is evaluated from table A17 by interpolation corresponding to temperature 2 is equal to 543.43 Kelvin. So we have to look this value, this temperature value at the table A17. So here we should look at the this value at 550, between 550 and 540 in the A17 table, because this is 543, you see temperature 2 is 543.3 Kelvin. So this is in between by interpolation 550 and 540. So we look at this value on the table. So 550 and 540. So here we have here. So this one here, you see this is temperature, this column, and this is H, this is enthalpy, this column. So our temperature to is 543.3, this one. So in between of 550 and 540, or 540 and 550. So we have here, in between here is 543.43. So we have to write here the enthalpy. So now we have to write here. So we have to write 543 minus 540, because it is in the table. So 543 minus 543 minus 540 over Uber 550 minus 540. So this is in the table. We got this one in the table. So this is temperature. So we minus this temperature with 540 to interpolate between the 550 minus also 140 because we interpolate this value. So now this is temperature, this area, this here. So here this is enthalpy. So how much equivalent of this temperature, how much equivalent enthalpy? So we look at this value with this temperature here, 555 decimal 74 minus 544 decimal 43. So now we look at in the table. Table A17. So this is the equivalent enthalpy. At 540, the equivalent enthalpy is 544 decimal 35. Here, at 550 temperature, the enthalpy is 555 decimal 74. So we have to write here. So we have to write here. So this is now the arrangement of the substituted equation. So we substitute already the value taken from the table of the calculated temperature, which is T2, temperature 2. Now we have here the 540 temperature from the table, and temperature to is calculated 543 decimal 43. This is calculated, and we have here the value enthalpy 544 decimal 35 from table, and we have also here. So this one at 540 and this one at 550. So the temperature 550, this enthalpy is 555 decimal 74 from table. So this temperature also from table. So now we will calculate this given data now. So here you have to minus this 543 decimal 43 minus 540 is equal to 3 decimal 43, and 550 minus 540 is 10. So here also you have to rewrite. So rewrite here. So it's 2 minus 544. So why there is 548 here? Maybe this is advanced. So this is not cheat here. Not cheat here. I don't have to erase this one. Responding. No. So I have to erase this one. It's not yet included yet. So now we have here, we have to rewrite the H2 or enthalpy to minus 544 decimal 35 So we have to minus this 555 decimal 4 minus 544 decimal 35 is equal to 11 decimal 39. So here we have calculated here, this is the result. So now if you divide this 3.43 divide by 10, this will be 0.343. So now we have to rewrite this. It's 2 minus 544 decimal 35 here. So it's equal to 0.343. So this one, since this is denominator here, we have to transfer here. So we have to multiply here. So this is arrangement or the revision. So we have to transfer here. This is a denominator. This is fraction here. So when we transfer to the transpose to other side, we have to multiply. So this one, 0 from here, 0.343 multiplied by 11.39. So this one. So this is the result. So we have to rewrite this one. It's 2 minus 544 decimal 43 is equal to 3.91. Now, since our unknown is it's 2 or enthalpy 2, we have to rewrite here the it's 2 and we have to transpose this value to the other side. So now here is minus. So in the algebraic expression, if you transpose this value in the left side to the right side, since this is negative, this will become positive. So we will remain here the h2. So h2 is equal to 3.91. We transpose this value, so this one, this will become plus. So plus 544 decimal 35. So we have to add this one, 391, 3 decimal 91 plus 544 decimal 35. So this one will be 548 decimal 256. Or in my calculator, so this is the same, 548 decimal. This is in my calculator, 548 decimal 256. And here this is in the answer to the calculation. So this is just a round off to 256 is 26 round off. So this is the answer of enthalpy 2. So now we solve already the temperature 2 and enthalpy 2. So here, we will continue with the process 3 and 4. So, we already solved the process isentropic compression here. The isentropic compression here from 1 to 2. So we already solved the temperature 2 and we already solved the enthalpy 2. So from 1 to 2, the isentropic compression. So now we will solve the 3 and 4 here. So the isentropic expansion 3 and 4. So now
So here we will solve the 3 and 4 isentropic expansion or power of an ideal gas, power of the turbine. So temperature 3 we have given 1300 Kelvin. So taken from the table, we will look at the table A17 1300. So the value there is 1395.97 kilogram, kilojoule per kilogram, taken from table A17. So this is enthalpy and this is temperature. So we will look at from the table. So you see, temperature, we have here the 1300, the enthalpy is, or the enthalpy H3 is 1395.97. So we have to write here. So this is not the one. So we have to write here one, the temperature 1300 Kelvin, the enthalpy H3 is equals to 1395.97 kilojoule per kilogram from table A17. So here our temperature 4 and pressure 4 to the power of 1 minus K over K is equal to temperature 3 multiplied by P3 to the power of 1 minus K over K. So to rearrange this formula, T4 is equal to, so I write this way rather than this way. So T4 is equal to, temperature 4 is equal to temperature 3 multiplied by pressure 3 over P3 to the power of 1 minus K over K. So remember that our P3, P2 and P4 is 8, the value. And P1 is equal to P3 is equal to P1. So we have to substitute the value. So now, if you calculate this here, this one, this will become 0.2857. So now if you divide this 1 over 8 P3, so because P1 is 1 and P3 is equivalent to P1, so 1 over 8, P4 is 8. So now if you divide this 1 over 8 to the power of 0.2857 multiplied by 1300, you got your T4 is 717.66. So that one. So here, H4 is evaluated from table A17 by interpolation. So corresponding to T4 is equal to 717.66 Kelvin. So we have to look this value from A17. So 717, so it is written there between 720 minus 710. So we have to interpolate. By interpolation, by look at the table, 717 decimal 66 is in between of 720 minus 710. So in the enthalpy, in the table A17, 720 and 17 we have here. Table A17. So we have here 7. Here. So at 720, the enthalpy is 734 decimal 8. At 710, the enthalpy is 724 decimal 4. So we have to write here. So we have to write here. So at 17, 700, between 720 and 717 decimal 66 is between 720 and 710 temperature. So at 17, the value, the enthalpy is 724 decimal 04. At 720, the value enthalpy is 734 decimal 8. So minus the value. So H4 minus 720 decimal 04 divided by 734 decimal 8 minus 724 decimal 04. So this is this one will be the denominator. Is equal to 717 from calculated 34 decimal 66 minus 710 over 720 minus 710. So if you do that calculation, so I have arranged here the, so here, so I rearrange here, so you must write like this to avoid confusing. So I rearrange this one. So if this one, you minus this value, 734 decimal 8 minus 724 decimal 04, you got 10 decimal 78. So you have to rewrite here. It's 4 minus, or enthalpy 4 minus 724 decimal 04. So here, if you minus this one, 717 decimal 66 minus 710, you got 7 decimal 66. 720 minus 710, you got 10. So here, you have to divide this one. So you got 7 decimal 66 divided 10 is equal to 0 decimal 766. So here, you have to rewrite this one. And then you have to rewrite this enthalpy 4 or H4 minus 724 decimal 04. And then is equal to 0 decimal 766 multiplied. So you have to transpose this to the right side. So this is denominator, so you have to multiply here to the right side. So multiplied by 10 decimal 78. So you got here the 8 decimal 25748. So you have to write H4 minus 724 decimal 04. Since you need to calculate the unknown, this one, so you have to remain the H4 here. So it's equal to 8 decimal 25748. You have to transpose this value to the right side. So in the algebra, if you transpose the left side, since this is negative, to the right side, this will become positive. So 8 decimal 25748 plus 724 decimal 04. So you got H4 is equal to 732 decimal 29 kilojoule per kilogram. So we already solved temperature to enthalpy 2 and enthalpy 4. We already solved. So now we have here so we already solved the enthalpy 4. So now we have to, so we already solved the gas temperature at the exit of the compressor and the turbine. So which is the exit from the compressor is H2 or enthalpy 2 and temperature 2 and temperature 4, the exit from the turbine. At the turbine, the exit gas temperature at the turbine is H temperature 4 and enthalpy 4. So we already solved. Now we will solve the we will solve now the back work ratio. So RBW, we need to find the work input to the compressor and the work output to the turbine. So if you I will draw this one. I will draw. So this is the compressor. And this is the turbine. And this is the combustion chamber. So now we need to find the work input to the compressor. So here, how much this turbine and this one is the compressor. So how much this turbine, the work input of this turbine to the compressor? So this compressor will rotate this turbine will rotate the compressor. So how much the work input? So and the work output of the turbine. So work output of the turbine. So how much the turbine work output to input to the compressor? So this turbine will rotate the compressor. Now we will solve that one. So now taken from the table, our H2 is equal to 544.35 and H1 is equal to 300.19. So this is taken from the table. So if you minus that one, your work in the compressor is 244.16 kilojoule per kilogram. Now work in the turbine out, enthalpy 3 minus enthalpy 4 is equal to 1395.97 minus 789.37. So how come this, the H4 is only 732? So in the table, there is a value there between, so this is 732 plus, we have the value here in the table. Between, this in between, this in 732.
So it's hard to scroll without the mouse. Start to scroll. So we have here, in between here is 734.80 and 724.04. We have a value here is 64.53 and 67.07. So 732, we have to take the in between here the 57.08. So we have to add, we need to add to 732.29. So this will be 789.37. So if you minus the 1395.97 minus 789.37, this will be 606.60 kilojoule per kilogram. So our back work ratio is calculated. Back work ratio is equal to work in the compressor divided by work in the turbine, out in the turbine is equal to 244 divided by 606.60 kilojoule per kilogram. So this will be the result. So 0.403. In my calculator, 0.4025. Round out to 0.403. So that is the
back work ratio. So now, we will proceed to the, so here in percent, so that is 40, so 0.403 multiplied by 100, that will be 40.3%. So see, point 403 times 100, so 40.3% of the turbine work. So the turbine work here the work of the turbine to turn the compressor is 40%. 40%. The work of the turbine is 40% to turn the turbine. So now, to turn the compressor. So the work of the turbine to turn the compressor is 40%. So now, we have to calculate the thermal efficiency of the cycle is the ratio of the net power to the total heat. So here, so net power, so net power or net work is equal to work of the turbine out minus the work of the compressor. So work of the turbine, output work of the turbine is 606.60 kilojoule over per kilogram minus the work in the compressor is 244.16 kilojoule per kilogram. So the result is, if you minus this one, is 362.44 kilogram kilojoule per kilogram. Now we have here the heat added, which is Q in, heat added. So heat added is equal to enthalpy 3 minus enthalpy 2. So this is taken from the table 1395.97, and this is also taken from the table minus 544.35 is equal to 851.62 kilojoule per kilogram. Now we have here to calculate the efficiency. So this is efficiency in TH, efficiency. So efficiency work, net work divided by heat added. So how much your net work? Your net work is 362.44 kilojoule per kilogram divided by heat added. So how much heat added or heat in? So 851.62 kilojoule per kilogram. So this is equal to, if you divide this one, this is equal to 0.426. So you have to multiply 0.426 to 100%. This is, the result is 42.6%. So that is the thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency. Yeah, that is thermal efficiency. So now, the thermal efficiency also could also be determined from thermal efficiency is equal to 1 minus heat rejected divided by heat added. So Q out is heat rejected or exhaust. This Q out is exhaust, and this heat added is, this is combustion or ignition and combustion. So here we have to rearrange the formula. So we have to, since this is heat rejected is not yet computed, so this is the formula of heat rejected. So heat rejected is equal to enthalpy 4 minus enthalpy 1. So we We substitute the value of enthalpy for 789 decimal 37 minus enthalpy 1 300 decimal 19 is equal to 489 decimal 18 kilojoule per kilogram. Now we substitute the in this formula, thermal efficiency is equal to 1 minus heat rejected divided by heat added. So heat rejected, now Q out is 489 decimal 18 kilojoule per kilogram divided by 851, which is heat added here. So 1851 heat added, this one, or QN, 851 decimal 62. So we divide this one, the result is 0 decimal 4256. So you have to multiply by 100%, this will be 42 decimal 56. So we compare the answer here. So this is near 42 decimal 6 and here 42 decimal 56. So run off, this is the same. So now, under the cold air standard assumption, constant specific values at room temperature, the thermal efficiency would be, so from equation 9-17, so we have here Brayton cycle efficiency, Brayton. So 1, efficiency is equal to 1 minus 1 over RP to the power of K minus 1 over K. So we have the value from the table. So we substitute the constant here, the RP, 8. So substitute the value of K is 1.4 minus 1 divided by substitute the value of K 1.4. So this will be 1.81. So if you multiply if you divide, so I will review. One, so this is 1.4 minus 1, so this is 0.4 divide 1.4, so this will be 0 decimal 28571. So if you multiply that 8, press 8 times, so press xy in your press 8, then press xy in your scientific calculator, then input the value, what was the value? I forgot. So it's nothing here. .28571. So 0.28571. So 8 to the power of 0.28571 is equal to 1.81. So you have to divide 1 divide 1.81. So this will be This will be zero decimal 2.5 round off. So minus, so 1, so you have to minus 1. This will be the answer. 0 decimal, so 1 minus 0 decimal 5.25. So the answer is 0 decimal 4.475 or 0 decimal 4.48. Round off. So here it is clear that the thermal efficiency under the cold air standard assumption is equal to 0 decimal 4.48 is close to the values obtained by the accounting of the variation of the specific heat with temperature. So remember that here the thermal efficiency is 0.448, so very close here to the assumption 0.426 here, 0.4256 or 426, this one, and 4256, 0.4256 or 426 and 4256. So very close the assumption. See? So this one. Scroll. So this one, so here the assumption of thermal efficiency is 0.426 and the second is 0.4256, so it's very close to 0.448. So that is the solution. So we already solved the So we already solved the we utilizing the air standard assumption. We already solved the gas temperature at exits of the compressor. So here we exit to the compressor is, so I will
So we already solved the gas temperature at exit the compressor. So gas temperature and gas temperature exists from the turbine, and the work back ratio and the thermal efficiency. So I will stop my recording.